are Cleveland County children. We like to think they're healthy, happy children. Or are these children of ours really so healthy at all? Can you call anyone healthy with teeth like these in his mouth? Bad teeth are too high a price for any child to have to pay for civic carelessness. Any community can save its children's teeth. We proved that right here in Cleveland County.
But where do you start?
What steps do you take?
Yes, how can we organize our town for dental health?
How? Well, these ideas have worked for us and other towns. Begin by encouraging your dentist to take the lead. They'll want to help, for they know that almost every person suffers from some dental disease. That more than 9 out of 10 children have one or more decayed teeth by the time they're 6. That the Army has to provide nearly 1,000 fillings and extractions for every 100 men inducted. Get your local dental association to work with you. It's an organization that knows the facts on tooth decay, one that can help you plan constructive action. Then, rouse community-wide support. Work with civic clubs, church groups, parent-teacher associations, the local health department. Reach out to every corner of your county, the schools, the organizations, towns and rural areas alike. Show every member of your community how vital it is to strike at tooth decay and build dental health now. Leaders of our dental health drive sent a delegation to the state capitol at Oklahoma City. They asked Dr. Frank Bertram, Director of Preventive Dentistry of the State Department of Health, to help them get a sodium fluoride demonstration team to visit Norman, the Cleveland County seat. These teams were set up to aid in familiarizing both dentists and public with a new and revolutionary technique for cutting down tooth decay, the sodium fluoride treatment. Dr. Bertram agreed to cooperate, and detailed plans for a countywide campaign were worked out. Soon its scope was expanded far beyond the mere promotion of the fluoride demonstration, till it became a drive for a broad, integrated program covering the whole field of dental health. In developing such a campaign, it's essential that teachers get their share of training, background information, for the dental health program centers in the schools. If we're to save teeth, the biggest part of the job must be done with children before bad practices take their toll. Teachers, in turn, carry the campaign into the classrooms. The youngsters have fun with all sorts of projects linked to the program. They draw pictures, write essays, make posters, and they pick up a lot of information about dental hygiene, too. Soft drinks and candy encourage tooth decay. Children must learn to avoid them. In one of our schools, the Student Health Council took up the problem. The delegates couldn't see any reason for keeping such tooth destroyers in the schools. So by their own vote, they asked that all soft drink and candy vending machines be removed. Now the old machines are gone, replaced by something a whole lot better. Some schools have even staged sodium fluoride pageants. They help educate parents as well as children to the fact that topical application of sodium fluoride can cut tooth decay by 40% or more. once mother and dad understand the importance of topical application of sodium fluoride, they're more than happy to cooperate. When the groundwork of dental health education has been laid, the demonstration team went to work in our schools, applying the solution to our children's teeth, teaching our dentists and public health workers approved fluoridation technique, treating youngsters from every corner of the county. The topical application process itself is quick, simple, and painless. First, each child's teeth are cleaned. Next, they're dried. Then, they're painted with a 2% sodium fluoride solution four times, from 2 to 7 days apart. Tooth decay is cut 40% when four such treatments are given at proper intervals during childhood. But the team's job is just to demonstrate the treatment. It can handle only a small proportion of any community's children during its brief stay. That means you'll probably have to raise money to continue the work. Cash to care for all. If you live where there's a city water system, you'll probably want your community to install a simple fluoride feeder such as this one. Such a unit injects the proper amount of fluorine into your drinking water. You can expect it to slash child tooth decay as much as 60%. And it only costs about 10 cents per person per year once the equipment is installed. Oklahoma State Board of Health has already outlined the correct procedure for your town to follow in arranging for fluoridation. There's nothing at all complicated about it. Start by getting an okay from your local physicians and dentists and health department. Then ask your city council to enact a fluoridation ordinance. Once it's passed, equipment to feed fluorine into the water system can be purchased and installed. But fluoridation and education can't eliminate all tooth troubles. There's still a vital need for regular dental care. That means more work, more money. More concentration on this continuing four-point program to blast your target, tooth decay. First, build a strong dental health committee. Second, teach your town tooth care. Third, provide fluoridation for all, topically or in drinking water. And fourth, make available regular professional dental care. This, then, is one way to organize for dental health. One way to tackle tooth decay. These are some of the things we and others have done. The things your community, too, can do. A hard job? Yes, sometimes. Uniting people behind any program takes effort. But that's the way with almost anything worthwhile. And what could be more worthwhile than the fight for better health, better teeth, less dental pain for your community's boys and girls? Thank you.